Wildcards and VLOOKUP, XLOOKUP and SUMIFS. Today's question from Mohammad on YouTube is trying to look up the words Bank of America into text. It says, you have received money from the Bank of America account. And Mohammad even had the asterisk here with the ampersands. That's the whole trick right there. So here I have a list of banks. Here I have a list of text that has those banks in the middle of the text. And I want to get these amounts. So with VLOOKUP, the old VLOOKUP, it just works. What we're looking up instead of A3 is quote, asterisk, quote, ampersand, A3, ampersand, quote, asterisk, quote. And then just make sure to put comma false at the end. So we're looking for an exact match, an exact wildcard match, I guess. All right, and it works. Why does this one not work? Because over here it says we got it from Mellon Bank, and here it's BNY Mellon Bank. The other reason that this would not work is if we had character 160 spaces over here, like if this data came from the web, which it feels like it came from the web, then that would not work. The place where it really becomes difficult is when we switch over to the new XLOOKUP. VLOOKUP handled wildcards by default. So that's asterisk for any number of characters, a question mark for a single character. There's also special handling for the tilde. If you were actually looking for an asterisk, you'd have to put tilde asterisk. But XLOOKUP has that turned off by default. So this same XLOOKUP is returning no results. What we have to do, the optional fourth argument here is if not found. We'll leave that one out. And then match mode right here. Match mode is where we can specify that we want to use a wildcard match. So put a 2 in the fifth argument, and then the XLOOKUP will work just like VLOOKUP. As I was thinking about this problem that Mohammed sent in, what happened if we got money from Bank of America account twice? Hey, check out these new books from MrExcel. All of these were published this summer and available in print. Click that eye in the top right-hand corner for more information about that. If you have a situation where the same bank might have sent in money multiple times, well, then we're going to have to use, instead of VLOOKUP, a SUMIFS. And luckily, SUMIFS will handle the wildcards just like the VLOOKUP would have done. So we're looking through the amounts over in column F. The data that we want to compare to is in column E. And then here, asterisk, ampersand, A4, ampersand, asterisk. And it successfully finds the totals from all of those. Let's just do a quick check here. So alt equals, this totals 3822 over here, alt equals 3822. We got them all. Well, hey, I want to thank Mohammed for sending that question in, and I want to thank you for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another netcast from Mr. Excel.